For us, we are quite agile with our fuel mix. So we alter our fuel mixes based on the commercial value for petcoke vis-à-vis the domestic coal. As of now, domestic coal is close to around 270 rupees a gigajoule to 280 rupees, and petcoke goes about to something like 350. So we have already altered our mix, so it won't be too much of an impact which you would see going forward. So we have earlier we were 70% petcoke, we have almost reversed the situation.
All right. So also I'd like to understand a little bit about GST cut on cement, if at all and the decision comes through, which has not been the case until now. If that comes through, would that reduce the company's ability, or you think the industry's overall ability to go ahead and increase the price that is usually seen post the monsoon season?
Not really, basically supply demand decides the prices. So if the GST has to come down, if it is to come down to 18%, whatever is being talked about, then companies will reduce the prices to that extent. Companies would also want demand to pick up. If GST is reduced, there will be definitely some buying in which will come in. There will be some more demand which will it will accelerate demand. So I think the companies are not going to lose in that in any way. So maybe the price increases could be a little soft later on, maybe not be that frequent. But anyway, it will be getting compensated by way of growth in volumes, I would say.
All right, so talking about volumes then, what is the kind of incremental volume that we're expecting for the quarter ended September as compared to that of the quarter that just went by?
Normally, quarter ended September should be subdued a little because of the rains and things like that. But I think the demand in central India for Heidelberg, at least, it has been good. So it should not see too much of a variation over the previous quarters or on a like to like on a year on year basis. I don't think there should be much of a difference in that.
All right, so also I'd
I don't
like.
think it is going to be soft in any way.
Sure. So I would also like to understand a little bit about your greenfield project in Gujarat. What kind of capacity is expected to get added with that, and when that project is expected to be commissioned by?
Let's see. It is at a very nascent stage. It is not going to happen in a year or so. But yes, the intention of the management is to go there and in future and develop that greenfield project. So I cannot tell you a time frame, but when the time is right, I think the company is waiting for some approvals which are there. Once those come in, and then the company can definitely review that.
Sure. Also, the company in the con call has spoken a little bit about adding 10% of capacity with refurbishment and debottlenecking. I'd like to understand when is that the process is expected to be completed by, and we can expect this additional capacity. Also, if you could give us a little bit outline your capacity by the end of FY20 for that matter.
See, those are all realignment of the equipment. Okay, so optimization, we are doing the optimization part. So that is which requires a very small nascent capex which comes in from time to time. If today we are at somewhere around 92% on cement, but in clinker capacity we are close to about 80% utilization. So there is a lot of headroom for us going forward. If I say my clinkering capability, I'm not worried about. For grinding unit, we are already taken up a project for some renovation in our mills, and that will be end over by end of December. So that will see us some improvement in our grinding capability in our Central India plant, and that I think we can take up in 2 or 3, since we have three headroom for 3 years. Going forward, we can do every year one small changes and keep going on and not be really concerned about hitting the ceiling at all at any point of time.
All right. With that, how much do you expect the capacity utilization to go up, maybe by FY19 as compared to FY18?
Normally, I would say that capacity utilizations, if we can manage at 90 plus, that is good enough because that will be on a new rated capacity thereafter. So we have to go for certain clearances, consent to operate, things like that. Those also we have to do in parallel. So which we are already on the job today, not in a hurry at all. And as and when it happens, we will not be at least short in the market. That is for sure. We won't lose the opportunity that there is a demand there and we don't have cement. That won't happen.
All right. Given the optimistic picture that you're painting about the demand as a whole, what kind of price hike are we expecting for the quarter gone, for the coming month, or for that matter by the end of December, because this is the season for a price hike?
Normally you say about 10 to 20 rupees a bag should be going up in the coming 2 months, 2-3 months.
All right, so the last question that I have for you relates to your debt picture in that case. I'd like to understand your outstanding debt situation right now, because I was given the con call. The management guided that the company plans to repay around 150 crore of debt by the first half of the financial year. So I'd like to understand how much of the debt has been repaid and what is the situation going to be by the end of 2019, financial year 2019.
See, whatever was due for us to be paid in this financial has already been paid, which I mentioned earlier. Now going forward, our net debt today as of now, it looks like about 340 crores. 125 crores will be paid in the next year and 125 crores will be paid thereafter. So by 2021, end of 21, we won't financial 21, we should be zero debt virtually.